The Seattle Mariners have added a new weapon to their arsenal, a person who will help players and staff take their respective games to the next level. Please welcome the M's first ever Director of High Performance, Dr. Lorena Martin. How are you?
Great.
Yeah. It's amazing to meet you, and what a cool thing. So this is, how did this come about that there is such a job?
Well, I think it was destiny in a way. So, yeah.
Jerry DePoto decided this was important.
Yeah, and my understanding is that it has been in the process. It was in the process for about a year and a half. And they were just looking for the right person, and I'm glad to be that person.
I'm glad you are too. Tell us about your background.
It's too long for this, but I used to be a tennis player. I always wanted to differentiate between those that are amazing at what they do, mm-hmm. those that are great. And those that are good. So, for instance, Muhammad Ali versus, you know, let's suppose, I'm not going to say Mayweather, I can get in trouble, though,
but
or McGregor. And then, you know, those that are amateurs and didn't quite get there. So right. what is it that differentiates them psychologically and physically? And so I started studying about all from psychology to physiology.
And so obviously there is a physical component. Somebody has a gift, then somebody works hard. But up at the very top levels, they're just these teeny little things that separate one from another. And a lot of that is this mental toughness. And I'm wondering what that's made of exactly. There's a, you know, this TED talk about grit. Everybody yeah. sort of has this idea that there's a persistence we all need to develop. How do you think about that?
Well, grit is a perfect example. So that's basically how to be as, what an athlete encompasses in the sense of resiliency. So that was Angela Duckworth, mm-hmm. I believe, and there's a great TED talk on that. So assuming that the players and the athletes are at similar levels physically, right? You're not just going to say, oh, I'm going to be the best, and then not put in the hours and then be the best. So ideally, if you have the same skill set level, at that point, what is it that differentiates you? And that's, you know, that's where we have our peak performance model as well, that works on the mental skills approach. But these little percentages are what makes the difference. And so looking at also not only the mental part, but the recovery. Are they getting enough sleep when they travel? Are they doing the right things to get their body back in the place where it needs to be in order to perform at their best?
Right. So you're going to be dealing with guys who have millions of dollars and don't always do what they're told
yeah.
because they're grown-ups. So what's your approach to this?
Well, I think
how do you gain their trust and persuade them to do the things that you really think they should be doing?
My background and my upbringing, I think, help facilitate that. I take pride in being authentic and being, I would like to say, a little bit raw. So they understand that I'm coming to them in a way that is hopefully beneficial to their career.
Right.
So how to prolong their careers. And I get right down to it. I've worked with a lot of men before. I enjoy working with them. As you said, they don't like to be told what to do. And then, so that's interesting. But I've had good receptiveness in other jobs before, as well yeah. as in the Lakers. And before that, even a sports medicine director in another venue, where I was able to bring different cultures, different diversities, different ethnicities, I should say, bring them together, because we all got to know each other and they got to see the human side of things.
Tell us about your work with the Lakers.
Oh, it was great. My role there was a little bit different. So I was a director of just the sports performance analytics. So basically obtaining the information from the athletic trainer and the strength and conditioning coach, and then analyzing it and then providing a suggestion to, you know, upper management. Where here it's a little bit different role, where I actually oversee the physical therapist and the athletic trainers and the strength and conditioning and the mental skills. And, you know, now it's not only a suggestion, it's more of, okay, this is showing.
This is what we're going to do.
Yeah, this is what we're going to do. Of course, with everybody on board, getting suggestions from them, but then looking at the data to say, this is really what it's showing that can help them get that 1% advantage.
Right. Is it just players, or will you work with staff as well, with coaches and others?
So I'm open to both. I have had some conversations with the staff as well, and that's really, I think it's great, because I think nowadays, looking at all the healthy options that you can do, for instance, there's all these watches, right, that capture all this biometric data, mm-hmm. even how much you sleep. So helping them discern what is a gimmick and what is actually right. something that could be helpful, and then teaching them how to read their own feedback and what that means to help them.
So. And learn to incorporate that in real time. So you did bodybuilding and tennis, right?
Yeah, I
so
did.
Your own athletic background comes into this. You understand what the general contour of what we're trying to do here is.
Yeah, so as a tennis player, I like to think I was, you know, very competitive, and that was my end-all be-all from, you know, you wake up to the night, and then you have some bodybuilding pictures.
There's a bodybuilding picture.
Yeah.
Yeah, looks like you did fairly well. Well, we've got some excited audience members as a result of this photo. I think she knows what she's doing here. You also talk about work-life balance. And I guess I hadn't really thought about that. And sports and baseball is so overwhelming because it's like every day and 160 day. Games. So how are you going to talk to the players about that?
So that's something that it's difficult because athletes typically have these types of personalities. You know, you got to become obsessed with your sport in a way. So helping them find that right balance. And then the data will help them see when they're doing too much. So overtraining, when they start to see that their performance on the field is it's not as the best that it should be, mm-hmm. then we can start to look at, hey, why is that? Maybe you spent too much time in the training room and now we're having negative effects, as well as also when you overtrain, you become demotivated. Your body is kind of telling you, hey, you need to recover. So I think the data will also help in that sense.
This is going to be fascinating. You go off to spring training very soon, right?
Yep.
What day?
I go on the 8th, and a lot of pitchers and catchers will be there on the 14th.
Which is just awesome. Thank you so much. Please get us to the playoffs this year.
I am working on it. Okay. I'm working to do my best.
That's what we all want, right? The Mariners open spring training action in Peoria, Arizona, against the San Diego Padres on Friday, February 23rd. The game starts around 1 Arizona time. Tickets are on sale right now. You'll find links on our website. When baseball comes on the radio, I feel like, yeah, we're in that time of the year that I love. Up next, New Day Hot Topics with two of the spiciest women on the radio in Seattle, back after this.